The following program is suitable for family viewing. Well, non-family members can join in too.
Hi, I'm Victor, aka Kitchen Victory. Today on Taste Buds, we'll be making a classic. Something simple, but most importantly, adventurous. The whole idea about food is cooking with ingredients you know should be more challenging, and that challenge comes from your ability to tweak and twist. Today on the show, we'll be working with all of this, but most importantly, our star ingredients would be yam and fish. Did you know that Nigeria is the largest export of yam, and that we have over 30 yam species. The difficult part of today is I would be cooking alone, but I'll be cooking for a very beautiful girl. It's just past Valentine, and I'm thinking, would I be able to win this girl's heart with whatever happens here today? You don't go nowhere. We'll be right back. To make today's special dish for special Amaka, we'll be cooking with, like I said, yam, and of course we have a croaker. And I'm still thinking, do I stew it, make a pepper soup out of it, or just serve it to her raw? No, just kidding. And we have our assortment of vegetables. Ugu. The whole idea is keeping it African, and most importantly, Nigerian. We undermine the nutritional components that our indigenous plants offer. Like, I know growing up, my mom would always squeeze this and she'd put a little bit of salt and sugar and she made us drink that. It was really gooey back then because I didn't understand. It felt like brutality, but I do that now and I could pass for a candidate that donates blood. Most importantly, the ugu leaf is really rich in vitamins. It also contains thymine, which also cleans your colon. So for people who have cloggy chest and nasal tracts, this should be your best friend. We're pairing that with bell peppers. Bell peppers basically bring color to the dish. It has to pop in the eye, like a judge would say, Dr. Roberts, you eat with the eyes first. So I'm trying to infuse a lot of color and fat. Yes, egusi. Funny enough, like, I think if a lot of people see egusi, the first thing that comes to their mind is egusi soup. Beyond egusi soup, you might probably want to think of egusi stew. But no, that isn't happening today. We'll be toasting this and at the same time, caramelize it. Oh, sorry, pardon the culinary grammar. Caramelize, basically, we're going to brown it with a bit of sugar so that it brings a sweetness to our dish. And enough said. We have ginger. Ginger. Ginger could just remind you of Terry G because he's like ginger master, but this is not a Terry G show. Ginger for our dish would bring in a punch to the fish and at the same time add flavor to the dish. Enough said, it's time to introduce the wonderful girl and try to win her through food. Peace out. Welcome back. To share this beautiful moment and this lovely kitchen with me today is the evergreen and beautiful Amaka. Yay! A lot of things have happened, but having to impress, you can see, oh, look at you.
Hi, Victor.
Welcome, gorgeous. Mm. I hope it wasn't hectic coming all the way.
No, it wasn't. Trust me.
Sorry, I should have asked. Which is your favorite meal?
Yam, actually.
No, oh my God, no, that's not true. That's not true.
True.
Are you, is this like a punk show?
No.
Yam is your favorite?
Yes.
Welcome.
Thank you.
Welcome. Thank you. Okay, she's here and today we, like we said, it's about indigenous food. It's about taste buds. You're going to help me get that apron.
Okay.
And we're going to get right with it. Asanwa, baby. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Okay, this is me. And then there's a surprise for you as well.
Am I going to use this?
Yes. There you go. Knock yourself out. So while I lace up, welcome. And then who heard that Amaka's favorite thing to eat is yam? I feel like I just nailed the car in the bag.
So,
okay, let's just do this.
Okay.
So that you're very safe.
Okay.
I'll just do this.
No, that's okay. Really easy.
Okay, that's there you go. Oh, you look like it was made for the kitchen. And what's up with what you're wearing? It looks really cool.
Thank you. I need it.
You did?
Yes, I did.
What's up with all the surprises today?
Surprise day.
Nice.
So, do I get that?
Okay, let's get to work. So, we have Egusi. We'll try as much as possible to not cook Egusi soup with it.
So, what are we going to be making with Egusi?
Let's make that a surprise. Yes.
Okay, can't wait.
Okay, can't wait. And then, enough said, let's get to work. So, it's her favorite thing to eat, the yam. So, while Amaka is giving us about 1 inch or less slices of yam, I would be filleting, scaling, gutting the fish. So, Amaka, talk to me. What's the meaning of your name?
You can take a long guess.
Amaka, considering your Igbo, would I want to peg it at? Amaka means my wealth has come.
No, definitely a no.
Amaka. I'm like beauty.
Yes, it is beauty. That's what it means. And it's not just Amaka, it's Ne Amaka. That's mother is beautiful.
Wow. Mother is beautiful.
Yes.
And growing up in the South, see the bonga fish thing was like...
What part of the South?
Okay, I grew up in Calabar.
Okay.
That'll be Cross River State. Ever been to those parts?
Yeah, I travel a lot.
So. Whoa. So you've been to Calabar?
Yes, I've been to Calabar. Yes. And I've been to Akwa Ibom.
You're kidding. All the way?
Yeah.
I hope you had fun. Did you eat that Afang thing?
I didn't really have fun because I went there for jobs. Some kind of work took me there. So I was basically busy and it was not for a long time, just short time.
Shame.
Yeah.
Oh, shame.
I'm almost done with the yam.
Am I feeling like a bad person? Please, the only community service I do is going to the market. I'm playing with those market women. Like all those mama yabo.
That's also nice. They will have fun. And
I say, how's that doing?
Fine.
Surprisingly, you haven't cut yourself yet.
No.
So this is me clapping for you. Cause
oh, a pleasure.
I wasn't looking forward to your blood though. So here we are. And then Amaka has done a very good job peeling the yam. And like I said, I was in clapping. So while you're off to wash that, I'm just going to wait so that when you're done, you just come and fillet the fish. I think I have a feeling that you're actually going to cook everything. Magic that's about to happen. So we talked about filleting a fish. Now you could see this has dorsal lines. And in the middle of those dorsal lines, you have this bone. We in Africa, we just like to eat the fish and munch the bone. But for these purposes, we have to take out the bones. Like, you can see how I don't want any form of first aid. It would not be nice if Amaka, because of how nice the food is, mistakenly took a bone down her throat. So here we go. Amaka has yam washing.
Fine.
Looks like an activity. So I have two knife options. I have my chef knife option, and I have my lethal paring knife option. Why I want to go with this is it's lighter and it's more flexible compared to having to use this.
Okay, so we're going to boil the yam now.
Yes, yeah,
so
it would be nice to have that on fire. And it has to be there for like 10 minutes.
Okay.
There's a texture we have to achieve. Okay. People also think that cooking yam should take 20 minutes, 1 hour, 30 minutes. Research. My research, not yours. Maybe probably I use a faster burner. Or a better cooking technique. But at 10 minutes, the yam is just firm enough to give you that firm bite. And you also want to not lose the complex starch, which is the carbohydrate you need while eating your food. So up to the fillet. Okay, we'll just go run the knife just close to the fin. And then people say jelly. Hold this up and ensure your knife is just on the bone. And one clean swipe, turn on the burner. Yeah. Yay! Amaka, do you love cooking?
Yes, it shows. I do.
And if I saw you on the streets, okay, like probably the first time I saw you,
yeah.
If I was told that, this girl does this whole cooking thing, I'd be like, I'm very good. That girl is a Mr. Big's girl.
Why?
You're not the one that said your name means beauty.
Really?
Fine girls don't cook.
Cooking. No.
Not joke, oh, please, fine girls out there. It's
fine girls
joke.
Cook.
So this is my one clean fillet. I wish it was over, but it's not. I still have to take out the side bones. I remember being penalized on one cooking competition like that because I didn't take out the side bones. And the guy's like, Victor, what's the one thing a fillet shouldn't have? I wish I would have just said, okay, I don't know. I think most importantly is the fact that you're not cooking it for too long because you're also trying to retain
the
maximum nutrient.
Yes, yes,
so
I guess so.
It basically needs like little or almost no heat.
Yeah.
Smart. Nice one, Amaka.
Thank you.
Finally. Finally, I wish. I still have to take off bones. Oh. Amaka, this is what? Cat food. Now you can imagine how much fun we would have had if we didn't have to fillet the fish. Because when you're done with this, you can still nibble. You can even use the fish as a toothpick, pick tooth. Yes, but I'm going to show you what you do with fish carcass.
Okay. So I'm going to be cutting the ugu in tiny bits.
Yeah, tiny bits would be nice.
Okay.
We don't want to lose it in the whole process.
Okay.
Amaka, you're chopping those vegetables really beautifully. I feel so bad. It just looks like we should just take a picture or put it in a show glass. But now, it looks a bit of Picasso this way.
Okay.
Yes, I could use that as well. So I said it looks a bit of Picasso, yeah?
Yeah.
So I'm thinking, rather than throw this away.
Okay.
Or usually it's meant for stock, but I don't think we need to make stock.
Okay,
except, so are we planning to cook soup tomorrow?
No, we're not.
So we'll just do a little bit of salt.
Salt? Is it just going to be salt or we have other varieties of seasoning?
No, I'm just working salt because the fish, not just the fish, ingredients, food properties have their taste, their unique taste. And
okay. You
don't want to lose that. You know, most times your fish would end up tasting like beef.
Yes, I
do. Do you understand?
Yes.
It's because we tend to overspice things and overseason things, and that way we now lose the essence. So I'm probably eating chicken, and I think chicken is goat meat.
I thought that just brings out a lot of flavor. Taste.
We get it wrong. Get it wrong. Flavor is not or shouldn't be complicated.
Now I feel bad.
Get dishes that go up, as in you could step up the notch and say, "This is what I want to achieve." But if it shouldn't lose the essence, as in when fish starts tasting like pomo, there's a problem.
Okay.
So all we just did now was salt, and I threw in a little bit of sugar, maybe a little bit of oil since it's going into the oven, so I could just have that gloss.
So is this fine?
Sesame. That is perfect, darling.
Okay.
That is perfect. So here we go. Voila. And bake. Top with the yam.
That actually looks perfect.
Yeah, that, like I said, the Picasso in me. The things you do when you're working with a pretty lady.
Let me check this.
Just pop up. Anything in school. Should I tell you something?
What?
Do you think we can still elevate the taste and the presentation of that yam?
Yes, I think so.
Should we do that?
I'd like that. So
okay, so let's just take that off the strainer.
Okay.
Now remember the part I said, I wish like job was over, but it's not. We still have to take off little dorsal bones.
Wow.
Yeah, that is where the fillet thing
is.
Yes. That is when you know what you're doing, basically. Because we just ignore it and that's where you get in trouble. And it's usually not too easy.
That's
a lot of work.
That's why we should be paid more, you know. So there we go. I think I'm basically looking for about 13 bones.
13?
Yes. So we're almost there.
So are we also going to bake this?
No, we're going to pan sear this for color.
Color.
Presentation matters.
There's a particular color, or it's just going to be whatever
color. I think it needs to look beautiful. The whole idea is I'm trying to make the dish that complements how you look. So on the plate, it should somewhat look like you.
Dashing, I guess.
Yeah, colorful, dashing, most important, beautiful.
Presentable.
Yeah, so we're now run a knife. Let's do triangles. What's your favorite shape?
Square.
A square?
Yes.
What's a square again?
Square.
Square looks like equal sides.
Yes, equal sides, yeah.
Okay, so I'll do triangles for me, squares for you.
Okay, fine.
So that's two triangles, three triangles. You know what? Often I'm gonna ask Victor why food? And I was like, the fact that I can play with shapes and colors.
Okay.
Using ingredients. I'm happy.
Fulfilling,
anytime,
right?
Yes. Anytime the dish pops out and the person or your client or whoever you've cooked for, loved one, enemy, competition, and they're like, that was one great dish.
You're done with this?
Not yet.
Okay.
So still flavoring.
Keep it aside for a while.
There we go. I hope these are perfect.
Perfect. Very perfect.
This is a perfect square?
Yeah. Not entirely a perfect square.
Okay, let's make it a perfect square.
Okay, that's good.
It's a perfect square?
Yes, it is.
So that's one we need to. But now because I have triangles, I have more pieces. I'll lend you a couple of my triangles.
Nice, thank you.
I'm cool like that sometimes.
You are really cool. And I'm sure this is going to taste really, really cool. And you are.
I pray.
It has to.
I pray. So
why don't you just check the yam?
Yeah, I think that's really cool. Strain, allow it cool off a bit, and then we'll continue. So this gear, guys, is my, I got 8 pieces, 4, 2 perfect triangles, okay, 3 near perfect triangles. What am I saying? 3 near perfect squares and 3 perfect triangles. Amaka is doing the squares, I'm doing the triangles. It's game on.
That will soon be ready, not just yet.
So we talked about seasoning. Now, what am I supposed to put in here? Curry, thyme, cumin, and all?
That's the basic idea of seasoning.
No, basically just salt.
Wow.
Yeah, just salt.
And didn't have that nice fish taste.
Just salt. Let's see how it goes.
Okay.
That's why you're here. You're the judge of the whole kiss. So there we go.
So let me check the yam.
Yes, please. That yam is... yam is cool. While that is on, what else? We're throwing a little bit of oil. Need to smell this.
Is there onion flavored?
Is there what and what and what?
Onion.
Snitch girl.
Belly.
Snitch girl.
What else is there?
Snitch girl. Snitch. You know, you're coming. You're talking to.
Okay.
I'm listening. They had. I need a little plate to transfer this into. Yeah, just drain the water and then lay them on the chopping board.
Does it have to be extremely soft?
Not, it's not even meant. I think this is even.
Okay. Right.
Yeah, please bring it down. So, like I said, we need to work with this. What you inhaled is what we'd call comfit oil.
Comfit oil.
Comfit oil.
Okay.
Every kitchen should have this. Now, your comfit is your flavor signature.
Okay.
But most importantly, it has to come from natural
elements.
So you have like your ginger, which is a plant, your garlic, which is a plant.
I
you have onions, which is the plant. So rather than throwing my curry, my thyme, and all of that that have been processed and kept in the shelf,
I just have all in one.
So all I do is just.
Wow.
There I go.
I think this is perfect, so we could just take it.
Rock that bowl.
Okay. So let me drain this.
I can't wait. So basically, like I said, comfy oil, the aroma is robust, intoxicating, intimidating. As in, you should cook and your neighbors wonder what's going on. If you cook and your neighbors are like, you don't come again. And when they say you don't come again, all they refer to is the smell of crayfish and...
Not all the time.
That's what I'm saying. We just...
I know we're very particular, but I don't think it's everybody who does that.
No, it's not everybody. Yeah. Like, I was just like, sure. This is me making sarcasm. Okay, now we're going to transfer that into the chopping board. Onto the chopping board, basically.
Okay.
The white chopping board. So this is me making space for you. So while that's on, nice. While that's on, I'm going to still shave some of my ginger onto my fish.
Okay.
Some people now say cooking organic. Okay, so before I do that, we're going to now clear this. Because we still have to chop up the onions, the pepper, the bell peppers.
So do I just put the yam on the white chopping?
Yes.
Okay.
Nice. And await my instructions.
Okay.
That's me feeling like like those, one of those. Hey, yes, chef. Okay, remember we're talking about natural flavors. We're talking about how to enjoy food and at the same time the healthiest form. So this is me. I'd already seasoned my fish with salt, like you saw, and my comfit oil, which is basically a mixture of garlic, ginger, onions, basically, in any oil. But for me, I have olive oil in there. You can use any vegetable oil. And to allow all those flavors to come out, you need to have this in here for about 4 days, 2 days max, because those flavors need to jump out of the ingredients and into the oil. Stephanie. We have some ginger. Do you know ginger works really well with fish?
With fish? No. I don't usually like ginger, but I think it has a lot of things to do with our health that it helps, but I don't think I like it.
It detoxifies. Most importantly, we live in a congested area, Lagos State. You have about how many million people?
1.5.
So you need to also understand that every day you step out, you're exposed to dangerous what gas is from companies, cars, and all of that.
Yes, yes.
Then we also live in the tropics, so it's usually very hot.
True.
So it means that your skin most times exfoliates. Fall in love with ginger, girl.
Okay. From now on, I will.
So we have that. And while this is chilling, Amaka is on with the yam. We're just going to let this cool off because nobody's about to get burnt. I'm going to allow this seat for about 3-4 minutes before we start the fire action. So we'll be right back.